Now that we understand what variables are and how to create them and use them, let's talk about the data types that you can put into them. Let me show you. Before we get started, if you find this video useful or if you have any questions, I would love to hang out with you. I stream on Twitch every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You can also find me on Discord. The links for those are in the description down below. Now then, in simple terms, a data type is a specific format of data in basically any form of JavaScript. There are three main data types you'll be dealing with on a regular basis: strings, numbers, and booleans. Strings are nothing more than text surrounded by quotation marks, like what you see on the screen. A number is exactly that, a number, but without quotation marks. They can be either integers or decimals, as you can see here. Be aware that 42, like this, is not the same as 42 like this. Why? Because 42 with quotations around it is a string, and 42 without quotations is a number. One of the main reasons this matters is if you try and do math on different data types. For example, if you try 42 with quotation marks plus 8, you'll get the string 428, because JavaScript simply appends things to the end of a string when you try adding them together. It's the same thing as saying, take this string and whatever is next to it, make it into one string. If, however, you try 42 plus 8, as you see here, you'll get 50, like you would expect, because you can do math on number data types in the same way that you can on a calculator. Booleans are nothing more than stating if something is true or false, like what you see here. Again, be aware that something like true in quotation marks is not the same thing as simply stating true. The first is a string, the second is a boolean. Arrays are like groups of data. They allow you to store as much information as you need into a single variable by storing each piece of information into its own element. As you can see here, an array is indicated by the square brackets on both sides, and each element is separated by a comma. In order to access the individual pieces of data or elements, you call the variable and the index or position number of the element you're looking for. For example, names with the square brackets and then zero will return the string Billy, which is the first index of our example here. Names with square brackets one will return Aaron, which is the second element in our example, and so on. Notice how the first index in the array is zero. This is because computers start counting at zero, unlike how humans typically start counting at one. This might take some getting used to, but it's important to remember. You'll see more of this type of counting whenever we discuss loops. You can store any type of data in an array, including JSON objects and even another array. Be warned, though, putting an array in an array can become confusing fast. Let's say, for example, we have an array called names by first letter, where we store arrays filled with names separated alphabetically. if we want to get the fifth name from the array containing all the names starting with the letter C, you would call names by first letter, square brackets, 2, and then square brackets, 4. This is not a typo. Remember, array indexes start at 0. JSON objects, short for JavaScript Object Notation, are similar to arrays in that you can store multiple pieces of data in a single variable. The difference is that instead of indexes separating the data, there are keys that define the data they contain. You can basically think of keys as variables within the JSON object, as you can see here. Hopefully, you can already see the power of JSON objects. You can store any type of data in a JSON object, including arrays and even other JSON objects. In order to retrieve the data from a JSON object, you would call the variable name, then the key in one of two ways. Using our user variable example, calling user with square brackets and then the string of name, or user.name, would return Russ. For the second index in the hobbies array, you would call either user with square brackets and the string of hobbies, and then square brackets, 1, or user.hobbies with the square brackets and then 1. That just about covers the basics you need to know to use the various data types in JavaScript. If you found this video useful, like and subscribe so you can be notified of future videos. If you have any questions about anything covered in this video, you can find me on either Twitch or Discord. The links for those are in the description down below. Or you can leave a question in the comments. Thanks for watching, and stay awesome.